Good evening, everyone. Welcome to our evening service. We so much appreciate you for joining us this evening. Thank you for all those who came to church this morning. We so much enjoyed ourselves as we are back fully. But tonight we have an evening service that we are broadcasting. And this is due to time constraints and also financial constraints that we'll be doing the way we are doing it right now. So please bear with us. It's a great time, but this evening is going to be a wonderful, wonderful time. Remember to give. We need you to give so that we can enhance and boost everything that we're doing. So much appreciated. You can see the account numbers at the bottom of the screen. We have an account with Access Bank and an account with GT Guarantee Trust Bank. Please join us and you can make a donation or pay your tithes and offerings to those accounts using your e-transfer systems. So please do that to help us. It's a blessing for all that we do. This evening we have Pastor Harrison Aruna. He will be preaching, and is a great preacher in this church. Does many, many things. Let's take a moment this evening and just watch him this Sunday and listen to him. Open up your heart. May God bless you.
Good evening, everyone. It's good to be here this evening. Thank the pastor for the privilege to talk to the people of Christ. And I thank you all for your attention this evening. We're going to read from the book of Habakkuk, chapter 1, from verse 1 to verse 4. And I believe we're all with our Bible this evening. If you can kindly open to the book of Habakkuk. And I read, the oracle that Habakkuk the prophet received. How long, O Lord, must I call for help, but you do not listen? Or cry out to you, violence, but you do not save? Why do you make me look at injustice? Why do you tolerate wrong? Destruction and violence are before me. There is strife and conflict abounds. Therefore, the law is paralyzed and justice never prevails. The wicked hands in the righteous so that justice is prevented. Let's pray this. Heavenly Father, eternal King of glory, we thank you, we bless and adore your holy name for the privilege and opportunity to be here this evening. Father, we ask, touch our heart with your word. Father, do your way here this evening by the blood of your Lord Jesus Christ. This we ask through the blood of your Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. In life, we've seen a lot of people in my place, or the little I've seen, here in Baratra, I spent some time, so part of my livelihood. I've seen someone that was with us, was put to school, we went to school together, Polly, but along the line, he decided to give up for another thing. He decided to let go that for another thing. But people around, the parents cried and put him in order, but he refuses. He refused to come back in line. Likewise to me, when I was small, my dad would put me in order. If I do something wrong, beat or instruct me and ask me to do some things I don't want to do. But then I interpret it myself that this man hates me. He tell me, why would dad always tell me this, do that? Why don't him allow me to do what I wishes and what I wants to do? Never knew that he wants the best for me. He loves me more than I knew. And this evening, I want to minister on a message I titled The Prophet's Cry. Here in our text, we'll see the prophet cry to God. And he says, Habakkuk says, he said, how long must I call for help, but you do not listen? Or cry out to you, violence, but you do not respond? The book of Habakkuk explores the questions of why and whether God permits evil to exist unpunished. And what he's trying to say here is, God, do you allow evil to exist unpunished? Do you permit wrongs to happen? Do you allow sinners to go unpunished? Do you allow all these things to happen? He cried out to God. He cried out in pains and cried. He poured out his heart and his mind to God. God, why this? So have pastor, yes. Pastor preacher, day in and day out, year in and year out, talks about, you stop doing that. Put you in order. He cried out, congregation, don't do that. Come to church. Be on the same track with God. But we're not listening. We wish to do that which pleases us. In the days of Josiah, 636 BC to 597 BC, Habakkuk was troubled by the sin he saw in Judah. Despite the religion revival, God chose the prophet that he was about to bring the Babylonians down on his people as a punishment. And Habakkuk, in this, was troubled. You look at, in that period and that region we're talking about, there was a revival then. And he says what? He saw sins around. And he cried out, God, why do you allow this? God, why do you permit this? God, do you tolerate sins? The holy God. But Habakkuk rise on another question. How can the holy God use a wicked people as a tool? This small book has great value for us today. We too see a lot. We see the wicked one flourish around. We see the wicked one what? Prospered. And here in our own days, we ask God, these people are sinners. They go wrong against your will. They never keep your command. How do they flourish? How do they prosper? Why? God, we question God also. We ask ourselves, we are the Christians who go to church day in, day out, but things is not the way we want. All we expected, all our hope, all our belief is not in order with what we expect to see. And this is what bothers Habakkuk, that he cries out, that he pours out his heart to God. Why? The prophets cries out, God. It seems that the 21st years of the reign of godly King Josiah would have been a time of joy for any worshippers of the Lord, especially for a man like Habakkuk. A Levite, a devoted to God's service man, yet Habakkuk may have who was the temple worshippers leader, was deeply troubled when the event that was recorded in his book took place. He was troubled. This is a man that was devoted for God's will. This is a man that put himself for God's will. This is a man that focused and looked forward to see the will of God. This is a man in in the time of Josiah, when he reigns, when there was a revival all over. This is Habakkuk was troubled. He looked at this situation. He looked at what was happening. He looked at what is going on, and he was troubled. It was a time of revival, but also the age of sin, an age of sins. Like this age we are, talks about 21st century, that talks about technology age, and talks about a lot of things. And you can tell that children of these days, they are more, they articulate more than olden days. They have privilege to a lot of things. They have opportunity to a lot of gadgets. They understand things more faster compared to olden days. But the sins also prevail. Their technology, their understanding, their ability to understand some things at times made them to go ahead to do things, believing that they are in charge, believing that they have this privilege, they believe that they have the opportunity and the right to do that which they wish to do at any time. And this is what Habakkuk faced in this at this time. Josiah's reign, the king, had come to the throne at Judah at the age of 8, At 16, he began to see the Lord. And at 20, plucked out idolatry from Jerusalem. In the process of repairing the temple, Haggai, the priest, had discovered a copy of the book of the law. The book which God has given to Israel through Moses, which had been lost during the rule of the series of evil kings. The scribe read the book and hurried to Josiah in Kings. Talks about that the Shaphan, the secretary, informed the king, and the priest has given him a book, and Shaphan read from it to the presence of the king, and the king there does what? He went and the book had been tremendously impact on the had tremendous impact on the king. It contains not only the history of the nations called by the gods, but also gave instruction on how to live. And at the end of the last book, in the section we had called Deuteronomy, was a list of calls that God will call upon Israel, his people, for forsaking him and his law. And at this time, you're talking, no one that reigns or lives in that era could ever remember or obey or know the command found in this book. But immediately Josiah humbled himself before God and prayed for mercy. He determined to publish the divine law through Israel as a king. Josiah made a solemn promise to God to keep his command and his statutes with all his heart. Publish God's words, Josiah did. He required everyone to hear the book read, and every year he instituted the feast of the Passover. Josiah led all Egypt, all Judah, to keep it with great rejoice. Josiah, in his era, he tried. There was a revival that breaks out. He tried as much to put things, like we see in the church presently or in the Christian world days. We see there is a revival. People go to church. People worship God. People do the will of God. But other side, they are involved in a lot of things. There are sins that involve. We see people around, they scam people. They go ahead to deceive people. Deceive people and get rid of their money. Deceive people and get rid of their things. Deceive people and what? And lead them astray. And this is the era that Habakkuk was troubled. He look at this. There is revival all over, which everybody that worshiped Iran was happy and they rejoiced. But here he sees this is the era of revival. Also, age and age of what? Sin. When we turn to the first chapter of this book, it opens the heart and mind to us and expresses a complaint that must have been on his lips day out, day in. He said, how long must I call for help? This is a person that was a call for help. And it looks as if God is not responding. Which at times in our situation, we see some things. It happens to us. We see some things. So somebody offended us. Somebody get us upset at times. We pray to God. How we wish that this person, God can kill him immediately or her. God can make things go wrong for him or her immediately. God can put things upside down for him immediately. We wish that God to put things away from him. But it's not so with God. Habakkuk had loose. God, how can I cry to you? How would you, God, tolerate injustice? How would you, God, tolerate destruction? How would you, God, allow sins to go on? Habakkuk is there. Cry to God. Ask God. God, why are you silent to this situation? God, don't you see what is happening? He cried out to God. But you don't listen. And cried out to God. Violence, but you do not save. Why do you make me look at injustice? Which you see every now and then. Injustice. People that are less privileged, people that have no power, authority. There is injustice all over everywhere. Put them down. Feel they are nobody. You can maltreat them. You can do anything to them. Nothing happened. But Habakkuk sits here. He cried out to God. And God wishes. And God does what he says. He will bring punishment on his people, Israel, by bringing the Babylonians. And Habakkuk also cried, how would God use wicked people to bring punishment on his people? Babylonian as a tool to bring punishment on his people. He could not understand. The condition of violence prevents justice. It's difficult for us to understand these days. Why? The king powers might have been supreme in Jerusalem, where he reigns through his personal officers outside the capital. The administration of justice was a local affair. There were no code of sanctuary law administrated by trained officials, and enforced cases were brought to the individual, and the local elders who sat at the city gates, that was what then administered to that. So that now allowed what? Sin to move. That now, that is what breaks the heart of Habakkuk. Hey, look, these are not trained people. They judge these people the way they feel and they understand. But in the midst where the king Josiah is, he says, well, there is revival there. That everyone at that time, that also, they rejoice with it. There is revival breaks out there, but Habakkuk was troubled to see things around. God, why do you allow injustice? God, why do you allow this to go on? And he cried out to God. And what Habakkuk cried out for? He cried out for justice. How would God people act this way? How would God people bring shame, dishonor to the name of the Holy God? These are people that he expects to see them bring glory to God. These are people he expects to see them bring honor to God. But they bring disgrace and shame to the name of the Lord. See, how can God's people bring shame to his name? He cried out. He cried, God, do you see this injustice? You tolerate this. You tolerate destruction, violence. And he cried out. And I want to talk to somebody here this evening. Whatever the issue be, you have great opportunity to come back to God. Cry to God. God listens. God answers. It might not be the way you wish. It might not be the way you think. But God is there and ready to accept us and get us back to the land where we ought to be with him. It's a privilege to be here this evening. And you might be here, you say, well, I'm far from where I'm supposed to be. I'm far from God. I'm far from even having a relationship with God. Can I tell you, you're not far. Wherever you are, whatever you've done, wherever you find yourself, you have this privilege, you have this great opportunity listening this evening. You can amend your way. You can be that person God wants you to be. You can get to that destiny God has designed for you again. You can have that relationship with God again. And you wish, you say, I want that this evening. Okay, now, let's have all air power ideas this evening as we do that. I wish you can say this sinner's prayer with me here this evening. Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. I've sinned against you. And I ask for forgiveness. Forgive me my sin. I've sinned against you. Wash me as white as snow. Let everything pass away. Everything becomes you. I do accept you as my personal Lord and Savior. Now and forevermore. Amen. Let me pray for everyone. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We bless your holy name. Father, for the privilege and opportunity given to us to hear from you through this evening. Father, everywhere we've gone astray, Father, we ask, Father, bring us back to yourself. And as many that listen to this sermon, ask Lord Jesus Christ, touch our hearts and put us on the right track with you by the word of the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Creator. Bless everyone.